and we went out after shooting and had a few drinks quite as a group, and then we went to a karaoke bar, and I ended up doing a song in karaoke, and they were like, "Oh my God, you can sing." And then the next thing I knew, they'd written that into the show.
Hi, Tom. It's
Hi,
really nice to have you with us for Cancer Live. It's an honor to be able to get to discuss with the devil himself. you have a very impressive career. You started in Britain. You played in a show that is really famous there, that is Miranda, that I watched when I was younger. You are a musician. You have a degree in dramatic studies that you got at the Royal Conservatoire of Scotland. I don't know how you say that in British, but well.
You said it correctly.
Conservatoire.
Conservatoire.
Right. So before being able to go to the US and being famous, did you imagine ending up in a show like Lucifer? And how did you end up, how did you choose to play this iconic character now?
Gosh, did I imagine it to happen? I think I dreamed it. I mean, I obviously, when I decided I wanted to be an actor and I went to drama school, to the conservatoire and stuff, I hoped and I dreamed that I would have a career. You know, I think at the time, if you'd asked the 18-year-old Tom, what would your ambitions be? Or what would you say success was? I would have said, well, to be able to provide for myself just by acting, right? But not to be famous, none of those things, but just to kind of like only act and not have to like wait tables or work elsewhere. Just, and you know, that was how it started for me. And I was very, really fortunate with the way that my career sort of started. And I did go from job to job to job to job, and a lot of people around me, that wasn't happening for them. So I felt very fortuitous. But I still always dreamed and harbored bigger dreams about what this would be. And I looked at people with great careers and I thought, wow, I'd love to have the opportunities that these people have had. But did I ever think that it would come to where we're at now, talking about how well Lucifer's done this stuff? I mean, no. I didn't. I mean, I hoped and I dreamed and it came true, but you know, I didn't say this was definitely going to happen at all. But the part of Lucifer and coming along and stuff, how did I decide to, I mean, that was a case of, I got sent a lot of scripts. You know, I was a good place in my career. I got sent a lot of scripts about new TV shows that were happening in America. And a lot of them were very similar. And one of them was very different. And the one that was very different was Lucifer. And it was different because of the character and the way the character was written. And I, by about, what, the third page of reading, had laughed out loud several times. And I was like, okay, I'm really enjoying this character. And I would really enjoy playing this character. And it was it's as simple a connection as that. For me, that was my decision-making process. And then it was about convincing other people that I'm the guy for the job.
And did you say you connected to the character. Did you see yourself in him? Or did you think that you could bring something to the character that was written in the script?
It wasn't that I saw some of myself in the devil. The way the character was written was very specific, and it reminded me very much of a style of play that we'd done some studying at drama school about when you're doing like Oscar Wilde or Noel Coward and any kind of like writers of that kind of genre, where they call it high style. And the characters have a very particular cadence to the way they talk. And a tempo, and it requires like rapid fire delivery, and all of those things. And the way that the character was on the page, it was sending off these things in my head, going, "This is just like those characters. This feels like someone from The Importance of Being Earnest or something." But of course, you know, he then was the bad boy devil, the sort of rock and roll devil, And so I just kind of like infused that with a bit of like Mick Jagger, basically. And that was my starting point, you know. But it was so beautifully written. Tom Kapanos wrote the pilot episode, and he's the guy responsible for Californication. So he, you know, he's very good at writing deplorable characters very funnily.
You talked about rhythm, cadence. You brought music to the show because you're a musician. Mm-hmm. You play the guitar, the piano, even the French horn, I read.
Yeah.
Which is pretty unusual. But it's cool. Did you decide, was it with the writers that you decided to give him like this musician, sexy crooner aspect, you know, or was it written in the script?
Originally, in the pilot script, it was that Lucifer had this nightclub and then he had the piano at the center of it. And that was very much a focal point for him. And it suggested a lot about who he was. And he spent time on his piano. And, music was paramount in the script as a soundtrack, but also music is very important in my life as well. So I kind of understood that music was part of Lucifer's language. And for a man who wasn't particularly articulate about emotions, that's how he could articulate how he was feeling. So there was that kind of at the center of it. But then the singing and stuff, that came out by accident, really, because we were shooting the show in Vancouver early on in season one. And Joe and Ildi, our showrunners, were in Vancouver with us. And we went out after shooting and had a few drinks as a group. And then we went to a karaoke bar and I ended up doing a song in karaoke. And they were like, oh, my God, you can sing. And then the next thing I knew, they'd written that into the show. So not only did Lucifer just play piano, but he also sung. And I think they put the Nina Simone Cinnamon in the first season. And that became like the opening montage of Lucifer singing. It was nerve-wracking and exciting for me because I love singing, but I'd forgotten how much I love singing. And this show has kind of, you know, I've fallen back in love with singing because of Lucifer.
You say that the music is important to the show. It's like a character in Lucifer, mm-hmm. to the point that you made a musical in season 5. Can you explain why music is like this mean of communication for all the characters, not only Lucifer, to be able to express their emotions to the others, to all the other characters?
Well, I think, like I was, you know, like I touched on before, I think music is a language in itself. It's a universal language. Mm-hmm. You don't have to go to school for a harmony or a melody to kind of, you know, hit you and do something to you. You don't have to have gone to school to learn how to receive that. It just happens. So music's a very kind of primal thing. Mm-hmm. And, you know, with Lucifer, someone who is, you know, he has a facade of how he presents himself. But if you ask him how he's feeling, he wouldn't be able to tell you. But if he's feeling a certain way, he can certainly play something on the piano and you know how he was feeling. So it's just a kind of, it's a way of communicating without having to kind of expose yourself too much. And I think, you know, the show really kind of clicked for me in season one when I realized that, wow, this can be more than just a sort of a crime-solving show about the devil and whatever, because we had the episode with Father Frank, with Coleman Domingo. Mm-hmm. And he, you know, he was a priest, a man of God, obviously, you know, someone who Lucifer despises, but they had this kind of common ground and their common ground was music. And they had this amazing scene where they became friends via this piano duel. And that was a scene that you wouldn't normally see in a procedural TV episode.
Yeah.
And it was a scene that kind of was like, okay, we can go deeper here. We can, mm-hmm. we can really explore what this is about. And that for me was, that's why music is so important. And it just, it takes you to places without you having to think too much.
You said the word procedural. It's not something that we in France know a lot, but it's a show, you know, it's a cop show in a way. But Lucifer, really in the last seasons, diverged from the cop show and became more drama. Can you tell us why this sudden change or this natural change to a drama show, less a cop show, less sure. investigation, even though it was pretty nice to see another take at a procedural.
I mean, there's so many things at play here. When the show started out, it was a network television show.
Yeah.
Which means that if it's going to see its full quota of episodes, then we have to do 22 episodes for a season. Now, anyone will tell you that's really difficult. That's really difficult to write as an overall arcing, you know, drama for our characters. That's a lot of time to draw it out. So what the show did have going for it and was kind of set up as a premise was it had this procedural element, meaning that they're cops who investigate murders, and that gives us a kind of structure to come back each week and do that in the 22 episode format. What we were able to do during that time was, like I say, go a little bit deeper than what they normally would on a show that's structured that way, because of the, you know, celestial element to the characters, and because of, you know, other overarching things. It wasn't just about a regulation cop show. As the show progressed, obviously, we finished on Fox after season three. Mm-hmm. And when we went to Netflix, we only had 10 episodes. And Netflix weren't so bothered about the kind of, you know, the cases of the week. Yeah. They weren't, exactly. They knew at this point that people were so heavily invested in our characters mm-hmm. that, you know, they basically gave us free rein to do what we wanted to do. And there was always that kind of balancing act that we have to do about procedural versus character. And, you know, the instinct of the creative people is always to lean into the character side, and the instinct of the mechanics of a TV show and, you know, commerce and all that was to go into the side. We were allowed to lean much more into the creative side of character once we went to Netflix. That was mainly because of, you know, the amount of episodes, and mainly because of their sensibilities as a home for it.
Was it more liberating for you to be able to focus on the character and be able to mm-hmm. Dive on them and go deeper in them?
It was certainly more liberating. It's always more liberating to delve into a character rather than just do what the character's job is. That's always much more satisfying. I think the more liberating thing about being on Netflix, to be honest, is that we knew we weren't on network TV. The show is airing whilst you're still filming. And there's always this element of people looking at viewing figures and going, how have we done on the viewing figures? Because they're waiting to see whether we're going to survive, basically. And so you've got this kind of like axe hanging over your head the entire time. And that's not freeing. Whereas being on Netflix, we knew it was like, we're doing 10 episodes, or we're doing 16 episodes, or we're doing, and it wasn't like, and if we don't, and if we mess it up, then we're not doing any more. It didn't feel that way. It just felt like we're doing 10 episodes. So let's go and be creative and do 10 episodes. And it's a much more freeing experience and liberating experience in that sense, for sure.
Have you felt a change when the show was released on Netflix? Because for the first time, it wasn't just in the US, it was everywhere in the world. At the same time, simultaneously, did you feel a change or more pressure to play Lucifer, to play your character?
I definitely felt a change. I didn't feel more pressure. I felt the opposite, actually. I think we all felt vindicated when the show got saved by Netflix and came back, because, and the way that everyone, so many people spoke up. So it wasn't a pressure, it felt more like a privilege that I got the opportunity to go and do this. Did it change it? I mean, Netflix is just, it's such an enormous platform. And the power of, the collective power of it all happening at the same time, you know, because when we first started, there would be, we'd be like on season one here, and then in Germany, they'd be on like, you know, we want to start season two or season three here, they'd be on season one in Germany. You know, there's people like catching up and being slightly behind, but by the time we hit Netflix and it all dropped at the same time, that collective kind of snowball of everyone in the, you know, in different territories watching at the same time is huge. And yeah, it feels vastly different to where we were. And, you know, just as a, as a barometer, I would say my Instagram, because I'm not very good at doing Instagram, but I before we went to Netflix, I was under 1 million followers on Instagram, and now we've been there for 3 years. I have over 10 million followers on Instagram. And that's not from me being good at Instagram. That's just from the popularity of the show on Netflix.
So, you are followed by a lot of people, and the fans are really dedicated to the show, to the part where they manage to bring it back many times and to have many other seasons. What are your relationship to the fans? How can you thank them? What do you want to say to them now that the show has ended?
Oh my gosh! I mean, our fans have become part of the fabric of Lucifer. I mean, there's a unique kinship with them because of what happened, because they saved the show, because they said, "No, we don't accept this. We're watching that. Sorry, carry on making it, please." You know, and they didn't stop. And they didn't do it in a particularly aggressive way. They did it in a way that really kind of inspired me. It was full of love, and it was full of like, we just really, you know, and what happened through that process, and that has happened over the years, is that I speak to so many fans of our show who've become friends with each other because of the show, because they've, you know, this has been the common denominator, and they've gone on to become friends with these people, and they meet up and they do these, you know, and that to me is like, wow, it's really incredible to think that our fans, for a show about the devil, we've inspired a lot of kindness in people. And that makes me so happy.
That's the beauty, actually, of Lucifer. It's a show that plays with biblical myth and with biblical characters, and actually is way more human than supernatural. Do you think that we need shows like that, supernatural or fantastic shows that can show us that we are, how we are as humans, and how we can be, you know, united, even though we have differences, even though we come in a way from another plane, we are dark angel, we're supposedly evil, but we are not. Do you think we need more shows like these?
For sure. I mean, it's strange, because I don't think when we set out to make this show, we set out with that in mind, but it became a lovely byproduct of what this show is and what this premise can do. It basically allowed us to hold a mirror up to humanity and say, here's your issues right here. Mm-hmm. Not some mythical kind of creature making people do bad things. Mm-hmm. You know, this is the people doing the bad things. You guys, you take responsibility, own up to your actions, you know, be tolerant of people. And all of those things, they came out of doing this, and they came out of you know, we're able to sort of humorous with the element of humor, shine a light on humanity's faults and the want for them to kind of say, well, I didn't do it. It's not me. We're all responsible for our own actions. And that's come out of this show. And if there's other shows that want to promote that as some kind of like message, I'm all for it, for sure. But like, we didn't do it for the message, we did it to be entertaining, but it's amazing that the message that came out of it, because we did it, the way in which we approached the entertainment was we did it from a place of love and care. Like, that's how we were with each other on the set of Lucifer. And anyone that like you speak to that came to work on the show, that was my biggest moment, my biggest sort of proudest takeaway from it, is that we created an environment at work where kindness and the way people were with each other was as important as anything else. And I think that came through on screen.
Which is pretty rare, actually. Now that the show has ended and you look back to everything, to how your character has evolved, how your fellow characters have evolved as well, is there anything that you miss, that you wanted to do on the show that you haven't had the opportunity to do? Or is there something that you wanted to see that actually didn't happen? I know it's a hard question.
But... yeah, but honestly, I feel like we did it all. That's the thing. I mean, there were so many, I loved playing Lucifer for so many reasons, because he was a multifaceted character, and I got to, you know, I got to do music, I got to fight, I got to be funny, I got to be sad, I got to be like all the things in this one thing. And not only that, you know, outside of my experience on it, I feel like we touched on so many areas with what we could do with these characters that I think we left it all out there. And that's why I feel satisfied. I feel like when we got cut off at season three, if you'd asked me that same question, I would have been like, God, there's so much. But now I feel like we really left it all out there. We left it out on the ice.
Did you work at some point with the writers on the evolution of the storyline by the end of it? Or did you all brainstorm to know where your characters and how you're going to come to the end of the show? Because ending a show is something really hard, because you have to say goodbye to the characters, but you also have to say goodbye to the viewers. Mm-hmm. Did you work on that with the showrunners and the writers?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as the show grew, I became more and more involved I became a producer on the show, and you know, became more and more involved with just communicating with the writers outside of like filming. And Joe and Ildi, our showrunners, and myself, you know, we really love this show, and we really had that same feeling of like, we want to end this well, and we want to stick the landing, as it were. And so we did think long and hard about it, and we didn't always agree about it, but I think we all agreed about where we were going to leave it, where our final image was. But we didn't always agree about the journey to get there and stuff. But that was the best thing about Lucifer, was it had this collaborative feel from the start, and the best idea won. It wasn't like there was someone, there was no like egos getting in the way. It was the best idea won, and we were all open to that all the time. And so, yeah, we thought long and hard about that ending. And you know, it was difficult because we were meant to be finishing in season five, we were told. And then at the very, very last minute, they said, do you want to do another season? So we had to redo all the things that we thought we were going to do and move a few pieces around. But, in the end, yeah, I'm happy where we took it and where the cycle of this this journey went.
There's one thing you didn't do on this show, which is directing.
Okay, oh, then. Yeah.
Is it something that you are willing to do in the future? Or you definitely are an actor and a producer?
Honestly, I thought a lot about it whilst we were making Lucifer. I mean, I know that I probably would have been able to direct an episode of Lucifer because I knew the show so well and I knew our crew so well and I just knew what it was we were making. Mm-hmm. Directing something in the future, it's not a burning ambition of mine, because I think that I love acting so much. I also hate watching myself. So the notion of having to go, you know, do all of that sort of stuff, it doesn't sit brilliantly with me. But what I do really enjoy is producing, and I enjoy bringing people together creatively, and that being my role within it outside of acting. So directing, maybe not so much. Producing, yes, for sure.
So Cancelli is a festival about TV shows, of course. Mm-hmm. So and Lucifer is part of an ensemble of a DC universe in a way. And you had a teeny tiny part on a crossover. Do you think that your character might, you know, be able at some point to appear in another license, in another franchise?
I mean, I don't own the character, so that's a good question. Yeah. I'm sure, probably, there are always these kind of, the wonderful thing about comic worlds is that they can make up their own rules and they can, their own mythology, and characters can pop up everywhere. So I've learned to say never in this industry. I personally have no more plans to play Lucifer. But again, never say never. We'll just have to wait and see. But I think in the format that we know Lucifer and the show that we know Lucifer, that's the end of it for sure.
You were an actor on many TV shows. You played in big TV shows in Britain. You played in Doctor Who, which is like an institution in the UK. Is there a TV show that you really want to be able to have a part in? That is actually...
Oh, yes. Succession.
Really? Why is that?
Oh,
What do you
God,
love about this
because I
show?
just think it's the best thing on TV at the moment. The writing is phenomenal. The acting is phenomenal. It's entertaining. It's the first show in a long, long time where I just cannot wait for the next episode. So, yes, Succession.
Hoping they will hear you, maybe. Who knows?
Anybody? Anybody?
You played also in Once Upon a Time. Is there a character that you haven't had the ability to play in a show or maybe a movie? Is there a type of character that you really want to be able to play in your career that you haven't had the opportunity to do?
I mean, so many. There's so many characters. And type of character, I mean, for example, like, people are asking me what I want to do next. And, like, what I love and loved about acting before Lucifer came along was the variety that it throws up. And I love playing different parts. And I love, and that's always been something I've loved doing. And so I can't be specific about my answer, but what I would say is I want to do something very different to Lucifer. And for example, he is a big character. He's an over the top character in many ways. And I would like to do something that's a lot more kind of grounded, I would suggest, and maybe in a smaller world, something a little bit more, something a bit more like honest, like an acoustic set, as opposed to playing a big stadium gig.
I get it. Something like less dramatic and less supernatural.
Yeah, something very very simple about people. That's where my head is at the moment.
I heard that you played in a Netflix movie that you just wrapped up. Can you tell us more about it?
Sure. Yeah, it's a movie called Players. It's a romantic comedy starring Gina Rodriguez that most people know from Jane the Virgin, and myself and Damon Wayans Jr. And basically, the premise is this group of friends in New York use like sporting plays to help each other date. And they come up with like elaborate schemes in order to make people fall for them. And their rule amongst each other is to never fall in love with your target. And then Gina's character picks me as a target and ends up falling in love. And then chaos ensues. So it was a lot of fun to do. It was amazing shooting in New York. And really fun to play with new people because I've been playing with the same people for the last 6 years. So, yeah.
Do you feel that now that you've been 6 years in a show that has a tremendous aura around the world that you'd like to do more, low-key stuff and less dedicate yourself to another show that will go for, I don't know, maybe 7 to 10 seasons?
Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, the playing Lucifer for 6 years was a huge privilege. But I also learned during that experience what I want to do after it. And that is, I don't want to commit myself to doing something that is going to take 6 years again. Unless I absolutely love it and it works for me and my life and my family. So I've learned a lot through this process, but I think, like I say, it ties in with the variety. I would like the ability to play lots of different parts over the next few years. So that's another reason why I wouldn't commit myself to a long running thing.
And my last question, because everything has an end, is what we know that TV is actually, especially since COVID, has been a huge help, a huge tool to cope for a lot of people around the world. Can you tell us what is your relationship with television and TV shows?
I mean, TV is an opportunity to escape, and anyone, people have their own different way of escaping and their own type of program that they want to watch to escape. But I understand completely with, the world being the way it has been for the last couple of years, that that want to escape and that need to escape has become even more. So, for me, TV is a way of just switching off slightly from the dramatic nature of the real world. So we all have our different places to go. I often watch live sport. That's my way of kind of calming down, and doing all those things. But losing yourself in a different world for a while is really important. A good book or a good TV show is just, priceless.
Well, thank you very much, Tom. It was really a pleasure to be able to exchange with you these few words, and we really hope to see you in Cannes in the next festival to come. Thank
I
you.
hope so. It'd be lovely to be there and lovely to talk to you again, Asma. Thank you.
You didn't torture me at all. It was really a pleasure to
Thank
talk to you, really, as it was 3 years ago. You're a delight. We wish to have more
you.
actors like you. Thank you so much.
Ah, thank you very much.